You know, in the history of Southwest Florida football, they are some of the first names that you might mention, first that you'd bring up. Sammy Watkins, Jalen Watkins, Trey Boston, the best of the best who made it to the NFL from our area. But as Derek Kopp reports, the trio is now coming back home to help the community that once helped them soar.
Trey Boston, along with Jalen and Sammy Watkins, didn't have all the bells and whistles to train with when they were growing up.
You know, we were used to training in, you know, backyards, maybe at your high school. High school weights aren't the best.
Training on turf? Get out of here. Olympic-style squat racks? No way.
I remember being a kid and not having, you know, the access to those things, and same for my brother and Trey.
It still turned out pretty good for them, with all three having Super Bowl appearances and Sammy and Jalen winning.
Sammy Watkins out of bounds near the 11.
But what if they had something like this growing up?
Man, listen, we talk about it all the time.
The dream for the next set of athletes is coming true, piece by piece, with their facility, D1 Training, nearing completion.
This is a place where we can create a foundation for them so that when they do go back to their respective schools or places that they train, they have a foundation of, you know, what it's like to train and train like an athlete.
It's hard to tell now, but this 7,300-square-foot area will all be turf with 7 squat racks and will put people through a Division I-like workout.
For us, it was just a no-brainer. We knew what had to be done, and we just put our money behind it and knew that, hey, when we bring something like this community, they'll love it and they'll have it for life. And it'll be bigger than us one day.
Fulfilling lifelong dreams and getting to give kids that are in the same shoes they were opportunities they could never dream of.
For kids to have the opportunity to develop their skills, their athletic ability, is something that you cannot put a price on.
We have state-of-the-art stuff. And to be able to provide that to the kids, it's just mind-blowing because you know how much of an advantage they're going to take over it from the time we were here almost 15 years ago, you know.
All three owners will have an open house from 4 to 7 tomorrow and hope to open by the end of the month. In Fort Myers, Derek Kopp, ABC 7.